All right, then, welcome to the video. We're going to do something a little different this time. Being as I have said that the last 4 months of 2012 hold a very high likelihood of great agitation, great situations arising, the potential is most certainly there. We're going to look at one such predicted event that is supposedly supposed to happen tomorrow. I just came across this last night, okay, which is why I'm kind of rushing this into production here. And we're going to introduce some desktop recording and integrate that into this video. And we're going to try several segments here. And we're going to introduce a web site that has been put up by several Russian lady scientists who claim that cataclysms are coming. And they have a lot of research to supposedly back this up, and they say that tomorrow, on Saturday, September 22nd, 2012, is supposed to be some grand cataclysm. The only reason I'm doing this is because in asking for response from wherever as to what can we expect in the near future, what's going to happen? I have certainly had a constellation of very surprising responses over the last couple months, and especially checking into this one. It does seem that there is some sort of event that is going to take place. It looks like it involves water, but that water could be symbolic also. It could also be talking about the sun giving off coronal mass ejections, causing problems. I'm not sure, but certainly there does seem to be an upcoming problem, which potentially this website saying, look out, there are cataclysms coming. I cannot completely reject it just out of hand and saying, you know, that's nonsense. It's worth at least taking a look at, if nothing else, then to get the flavor of the times that we're living in, because I certainly believe that there are going to be some events coming up. I don't have the details of them at this point, but let us at least be aware that we are in the last 4 months of 2012, and it's not a joke. We need to really focus on the highest truth that we can. And after we look at these screen recordings, desktop recordings, we're going to again focus in on choosing a new idea. Yes, we can do this, and to get us past the situation. So let us jump into it here. And this is the first screen recording. I'm going to click on it and see how it works for us. All right, here we go. We are two Russian scientists, Victoria Popova and Lydia Andrianova. So begins the tale of these two ladies who in Russia have claimed to be able to decipher crop circles, and with the help of ET civilizations, which they shortened to ETC, have brought through certain knowledge and warnings about what is going to happen. Most specifically, if we go to their homepage, www.rtransition.info, a very interesting message pops up, and we'll take a look at it. It's in English and Russian, and we'll read it. On September 22nd, 2012, will happen cataclysm of incredible power in the Pacific Ocean off the coast of Peru in the area of the Brazilian magnetic anomaly. It will lead to severe contamination of the planet by radiation in the result of nuclear power plant's destruction. The direction of the blow and affected area are shown on this website. Extraterrestrials call humanity before this date to make the transition into the next cycle of life through the united consciousness of civilization. Extraterrestrials change the way of information transmission into emergency mode. We will present ETC's messages in two languages, Russian and English, online and through our YouTube channel, Our Transitions 49. Okay. I've been exploring this website, and this is not just some, you know, kooks putting out some crazy information. This actually, these are people who have researched deeply, who are tremendously into the messages of the crop circles, and done a lot of research on it and put up a lot of information on their website. So I'm thinking, you know, it's worth at least keeping an open mind to the situation. At some point, they put out this press release. Russian scientists decode extraterrestrials' messages. Grave warning for humanity. The Earth is in the final stages of a cycle of development of human consciousness and the organic world. A critical decrease in the Earth's magnetic field will cause global cataclysmic events. Extraterrestrial civilizations, etc., have offered humanity the only avenue for escape on the eve of these predicted global cataclysms. This is the claim of two Russian scientists, Victoria Popova, Doctor of Science, PhD, and Lydia Andrianova, PhD. They have offered over 200 publications and 19 patents, and they give in a series of 15 videos. During 15 years of research, they discovered two keys, analog and digital, for decoding crop circles and other extraterrestrial pictograms in stone. Among them are Stonehenge and Avonbury stone circles in the UK, Machu Picchu, Chavín de Huántar, and the Nazca lines in Peru. The pyramids of Chichen Itza and the pyramids of the moon and the sun in Mexico and the Moai of Eastern Island and others. All extraterrestrial pictograms in stone transmit preliminary information about the development of consciousness. Crop circles transfer the emergency information and instructions for salvation. Unfortunately, there are many hoaxes that can ruin our future. After decoding many hundreds of pictograms scattered all over the world, the Russian scientists composed a dictionary of over 250 symbols. ETC predict three preliminary catastrophes followed by global cataclysms, say the scientists, of a magnitude beyond anything experienced in living memory. There will be a short time period between all these events. ETC warned that civilization has to be pre-informed about the scenario of global cataclysms beginning event. Not informed civilizations have no chance to make the transition in time and to prolong life. First pre-cataclysm will be released with interruption of global system of communication, phone, internet. Pre-informed civilizations will avoid shock and chaos of super powerful disaster and has a chance to make the time transition in time. The first of these pre-cataclysms is imminent, an extraordinary event which surpasses all natural powers known by humanity. The scientists claim a catastrophic seismic event will emanate from the west coast of Peru in the area of the Brazilian magnetic anomaly at the intersection of the Humboldt and El Nino currents in the Pacific Ocean. An area of the United States from the Gulf of Mexico to the Great Lakes will be inundated as a result of a tsunami. According to prophecy of Edgar Cayce, famous American prophet, during several minutes the waters of the Mexican Gulf will join with... Okay, that was the first installment, and that basically there's sort of a contradiction there. We'll get into it later for the first cataclysm, the second one. Now I'm going to introduce the continue with this press release here, in the second desktop recording. It's 5 minutes here. Okay, let's continue off this press release. Continuing on. This catastrophe will have a devastating impact on the whole Central and South Pacific region, with the likelihood of mega tsunamis hitting the eastern seaboard of New Zealand and Australia. The tsunami may even affect the northwestern coast of Africa and the shores of Western Europe, but the brunt of the cataclysm will focus on the eastern coast of North America. The second and third pre-cataclysms will be much stronger. Scientists emphasize that this is a natural cycle of the planet. Part of this process is the development of human consciousness to a point where humanity will have a window of opportunity to make the transition to a higher plane of existence. They explain that this point in history can be seen as a kind graduation for humanity to a higher and more subtle level of experience, a type of metamorphosis for humanity connected with ascension. According to Dr. Popova and Dr. Andrianova, nobody can be saved individually, as the transition can be made only through the synchronous unification of human consciousness. The time for humans to escape the devastation through the unification of consciousness will be shortly after the first pre-cataclysm. After the second pre-catastrophe, humanity will have no chance to prolong life because the number of remaining people will not be enough to start up the mechanism of the transition. In the future, humanity will join a galactic community of evolved extraterrestrial civilization linked through consciousness. There you have it. That is a press release. They have some books out. Book one, The System of Information Transmission of Extraterrestrial Civilizations. I took a read of that. It's actually online. You can read that. Book two, Letters of Extraterrestrial Civilizations, The Last Warning, Smart Eye of the Laughing Fish, Earth's Mysteries Started Talking, The Criterion of the Transition, Phenomena of Consciousness, The Sphinx Laughter, The Algorithm of the Transition, The Future of the Civilization, Despair of Moai of Eastern Island, Our Transition into Parallel Worlds. Let's open up this first one, Open for Translation. And it will actually be translated from Russian into English. Actually, I have to click this translate button. Here we go. Try again. And there you have it. Marina Popovich, who was, a famous Soviet test pilot, is also involved with this. Transmission System, ET Civilizations. And you go through this... quite an interesting book here with many, many pictures and trying to describe a tremendous amount of crop circle diagrams here. And they claim to be able to understand the message of the crop circles. So this is something that's been worked on for a long time with a lot of effort. This is all crop circles that they have included here. Pretty amazing stuff. Just keep on going through this book real quickly here. Just to give you the gist of that, there's a lot of stuff here. It's sort of repetitive, they get into South America now with and deciphering what's the ancient buildings of South America, various complexes there, and they feel that it all relates to the one and the same thing here. Okay. So this is a in-depth type of look at the communication from extraterrestrials and their conclusions regarding this. The ultimate conclusion is that cataclysms are upon us, and supposedly continue. All right. That was the end of the second recording I did. We're going to do one more recording, and then we'll kind of give a synopsis and a take on it all and sort of break it down, look at it more carefully. So let us finish up with this third part, and we're going to go to that right now. Now, although a very serious website, there seems to be some inconsistencies. For instance, it is claimed that the first cataclysm is going to affect all the communication of the planet. And then it seems to talk about also the first one being a seismic event causing a vast tsunami on the eastern seaboard of the U.S. And then it talks, says that, quoting here, according to the scenario of a global cataclysm beginning on March 20, 2012, the first pre-cataclysm happened. However, extraterrestrial civilizations constrained incredible force of this blow, preventing the consequences of a nuclear catastrophe. It revealed only in the form of a powerful earthquake in Mexico, 7.2 magnitude, without human losses. Although, ETC warned that the real blow would have killed 300 million people in a few minutes. The second free cataclysm, much more powerful than the first, should occur on September 22, 2012. How much ETC can constrain this blow? ETC would not allow overturning of the planet poles because otherwise humanity would be destroyed. For the transition, we are given only a small time interval from March 21st to September 21st, which is today, 2012, just 6 months. But we again are failing to act. Civilization can make the transition in time only under the leadership and active participation of the governments of the world. So here it says that December 22nd is the second cataclysm, and if we're not out of here by September 21st, we have missed the boat and we've completely failed to survive. Whereas in other places, like on the press release, they say that the September 22nd is the first one, and that after that we'll have a brief period of time in order to get it done. So there are some, you know, extreme inconsistencies here. It hasn't been vetted very carefully. Nevertheless, we're taking a look at this. They have a lot of pictures here on their home page, going down, just giving you an idea of the complexity of this site. And it's quite common in people who deal with extraterrestrials that the information, it doesn't come through in time accurately, and they have to keep shifting and changing and all of that. It's very difficult to predict the future. The basic idea of this supposed massive tsunami hitting the eastern seaboard is that it's supposedly going to cause problems with the nuclear power plants, and the plant is going to be severely contaminated with radiation. Also, in some places, they talk about 2 billion people dying from this, etc., etc. So they're talking about a very drastic situation coming up actually tomorrow, Saturday, September 22nd. Now, one would think that with a situation this severe coming up, that they would at least be able to get their story straight as to which is the first cataclysm and what is the second and what's going to happen, etc. You would think so. And here's this warning message that pops up when you go to their homepage that says, you know, this is going to be this incredible tsunami. So on the one hand, you have the situation where the story is not straight at all. On the other hand, you get a situation of an incredible amount of research on their part. So I'm not just dismissing this out of hand. There are certain parallels to what I have seen to not just say, this is complete nonsense. I don't know about the date setting on this. But it does seem like a water event could be in our future. At least after tomorrow, we will know whether their accuracy was on or not, and go from there. Once again, these are the two ladies that have been working on this for quite some time, saying that the entire planet has to decide to make the transition. It's either all go or none go. And we're going to talk about that next. All right. There you have it. Okay. In all its awful glory. One other thing that caught my attention was that I did have one of the most important dream scenarios I ever had was showing that there would be 2 minor collapses followed by a total collapse. And I took that to be referring to global economic and financial situations. But I could be mistaken. It's possible. It could be that there are 2 minor cataclysms followed by a complete collapse, a complete cataclysm. That is also possible. So that is why I'm not just dismissing and saying, nonsense, because I clearly was shown 2 minor situations of collapse, and it is conceivable that those could be seismic events, because it was like stone like on a wall suddenly collapsing and all these stones rolling out along the plain. Now it could be like a off a coast of an ocean, seismic events happening there and creating a landslide out into the more flatter under area parts of the ocean. That is possible. The reason why I took it to be a economic situation was there was this massive wall collapsing onto a street. Okay, that was definite. So wall, street, collapse of wall, street. That is how I looked at it. But it doesn't necessarily, you know, have to be that. And dreams are rather tricky to get it correct. So, and because of other factors I've been aware of, it is possible that we will have some sort of global cataclysms, and not just an economic, financial meltdown and collapse. You know, just some banks going under, some countries going under in the EU, and all of that stuff. It's possible that the Mayan prophecies of December 21st, 2012, it's possible they may be accurate. I don't know. But you know, it is very important not to put it to the test. From my standpoint, I think it's all important that we accept the vision of unconditional love, that we choose a new idea right now, that we don't wait and say, well, let's find out what happens with the end of 2012, because there's already so much agitation taking place in the world. You get this kind of uneasy feeling that really everything is shaking loose right now, and we're not going to some greater peace and harmony, and everything is not getting better, it is getting worse. And you know, there's so many different threads from so many different angles seeming to get our attention. So it's super important to continue with the satsangs, which I will try to make another video tonight, following up on this one, where we get into the right focus and the great simplicity of doing it right now, making this decision that right now we are going to choose a new idea. We're going to stop trying to make a hypothetical real. We're going to realize that nothing will always be nothing. And we're going to experience this unconditional love that is entirely stable. We're going to do that now. We're not going to wait until 2013. That's a foolish risk to take. More and more, I'm realizing this, that don't put it to the test. Don't put these times to the test. There's a lot of different prophecies and people speaking up now who are not just some pranksters or something. No, these are serious people saying that from what they see, there are really going to be some tremendous anomalies coming up the next 4 months. So again, why put it to the test? Let's not put it to the test. Let us choose an experiencing which is trauma-free, which is loss-free, okay, and cannot be affected in any way by the misery and the suffering of energy, okay. Let us choose that which is reflects essence, which is stable. It's not something that is vulnerable to any sort of transformation, transmutation, change, permutations of change, problems, cataclysms, collapses, all that stuff. No, let us choose an experience that is totally stable. And so whatever happens in the world is not going to affect our experiencing at all. Not at all. Just like if we're in a movie theater watching a movie about a disaster movie. And yet, you know, we're in the theater, we're eating popcorn, and we feel fine. And any moment we can take our attention away from the screen and realize that nothing at all is happening. It's that sort of a crude analogy, meaning that everything can be happening in the world. All hell can be breaking loose in the world. Cataclysms, collapses, disasters. And yet our experiencing will be totally blissful and delightful and stable, because we've decided that the impossible will never happen. We don't want to try to keep trying to make it happen. We don't want to keep trying to manufacture some greater power than the powers of reality so that we can threaten reality with destruction and force the Prime Creator to change reality. We don't want that. We don't want to try and seek the death of the Prime Creator, thinking that somehow we're in getting this, it will transmute us, the hypothetical, into the real, and we'll have a new creation. We'll be in charge of it. We don't want that. We don't want to keep trying for that. We want to say, look, it was impossible from the very beginning. Let us now recognize that, and let us accept this, the effects of this other idea that we choose, the idea of not trying to be Prime Creator, not trying to change reality. Let the isness, what is, let it be what it is, and let us not try to change isness. And in not trying to change isness, we will experience isness. We will experience isness. The I Am presence of isness is the I Am presence of isness presenting itself as unconditional love, meaning no conditions to get into it, not holding out any conditions. Everyone is welcome, equally welcome, no conditions whatsoever. That means we're welcome. That means everyone's welcome. Let us get into, let us choose that experience. Let it that be our experience. And then that will show everyone else there is a way. And then when they're in the midst of this trauma, at least they'll look up and say, oh, there really is a way. Even though we're befuddled, we know that there is a way, and there will be an end to this trauma. At some point, we'll be able to. And that will help them, no matter how bad they're going through it. It will be very helpful. Of course, many are not going to choose this because they've not been properly prepared in their clarity. But at least it can be helpful for them to see those who are not experiencing trauma, and that they will say, ah, at least it is possible. Good. Let me turn then to finding out how is it possible. And that will be, you know, the greatest help they can possibly get, really. So again, to recap this video, those three screen recordings of this prophecy by the Russian scientists, it's kind of muddled. They thought it. They said March 20th was the first, and this is the second, and we had to get out of here by the 21st of September. And now they're saying no, that the 22nd is the first, and that we have to get out of here before the second one comes. And they haven't said what the second one is going to be, nor what the final one necessarily is going to be. But it's going to be some. They have a whole theory about planets and consciousness and all this stuff, and it may be correct. It may be correct, really. It's not a crackpot theory, actually. How the development of consciousness in the universe. How it takes place. And of course, what we're talking about here on Christ Clarity is that the universe is not our home. Energy is not our home. So the development of consciousness is entirely unnecessary. It's a development of nothing. That isness already is perfect, always will be, and we are that isness. We are reality. Reality is. And there's no building up of consciousness and reality whatsoever, none of that. The whole universe and this whole play of consciousness and building up consciousness, etc., is just a dream. But within this dream, there is all sorts of plot lines and storylines and mechanisms, etc., to make this dream seem very interesting to us. Okay, and we've gone over that in many other videos. So their description of the way the universe works and how planets are destroyed at certain times, etc., could have some validity to it, really. It's quite a brilliant exposition of the workings of the celestial mechanics and how some planets are prepared to receive consciousness, and those who have already gone through that are actually then gradually destroyed, become gaseous, more and more gaseous. Okay. That does correlate to what I've seen in the future of this planet. Well, this future of this planet will be melted down to a very flat planet, and then and that's what they actually say as well. So there are some, you know, they're talking from a certain perspective, I think, with the best of intentions, but of course the non-dual perspective is not there at all, which is simply the universe is simply a dream. It is simply a hypothetical scenario. It's a nothing. It's a zero. Okay, that is not there at all. So it's very important to put it in the right context, and don't panic, don't get all freaked out or anything by any sort of catastrophe talk, etc., because there definitely is a way for you to be entirely free forever of any trauma. Absolutely there is a way, and it's very simple. Okay, So perhaps we will do a recording this evening of a true satsang recording, but I wanted to at least bring this up and sort of get us to realize that, hey, you know, we're in the times of consequential times right now, and people are saying stuff, making prophecies, and saying, you know, and let's be on our toes, and most importantly, let's choose a new idea. Let's experience the I Am presence of Isness through unconditional love and the trauma-free, loss-free, change-free, bliss-filled, delightful, steady, stable experiencing of unconditional love. Let's do it now. Let's not wait until 2013. All right? All right. Very great. That's it for this video.